My first thought when I walk into the building is I have another day where I get to see my kids again. I refer to them as my kids because they're not a name on the class roster. They are people that are very close to my heart. I wouldn't trade them in for the world. When I walk in, I see the big seal in the front hall of the school. I said, I'm here, God has given me another day, and I'm waiting for my kids. I had a young man come out of school one day, and he almost lost his mother that September. She was down at the Trade Center at 9/11, and she miraculously survived that. And Jorge was his name, and he came out of the door on a gloomy, sleeting, raining day. I had my baseball hat on with the interlocking AH on the top of the hat. And Jorge looks at me and said, Mr. Sullivan, he said, I know AH stands for All Hallows, but you know what it means to me. And I really didn't want to listen to it. I just was so tired. I said, no, Jorge, what does it mean to you? And he said, Mr. Sullivan, AH to me stands for almost home. And I was absolutely floored. It was like hearing a message from God. And I said, really? And he said, yes, to me it's almost home. And I had no response. And he put out his hand, he shook my hand, and said, have a nice weekend, Mr. Sullivan. And there's this little 5'6" kid going down Walton Avenue, 40 pounds of books on his back, trudging through the puddles that was there from the sleet and the rain earlier in the day, happily walking home. That meant everything to me. It came from a little 15-year-old sophomore. After all my years here at All Hallows, it hit home. AH is almost home. The only hours of stability that a lot of these kids have is the 11 hours that they're here. Many of them go home, going through difficult neighborhoods to get home, to loneliness, that there's the parents are out working two jobs to pay for the tuition. Could be a chaotic situation. It's their only sense of stability is their 11 hours here, and that's why they even come to school on Saturdays. They want to come to a place that is their second home to get work done, to experience success, and to be away from chaotic situations. We're in the poorest congressional district in the country as per capita income. Our tuition is the lowest in the city, and a lot of the kids can't afford it. And it's up to our alums and our graduates who are, without them, I don't know where we would be. They are excellent in contributing to keep these kids in the school. With each passing year, the building is getting better and better. The kids, our kids, they're going to adapt, they're going to adjust, they may improvise, they may not, but we don't give up on them. There are so many different opportunities here, so many different programs that avails them of the situation of getting involved and part of the final product, if you will, upon their graduation, that it's more than an academic institution. It's a lifelong experience.